Hey guys, how's it going and welcome back to another video where today we're going to watch Cardiff v Liverpool in the Premier League. Now, Cardiff picking up a great win against Brighton on Tuesday night, 2-0 victory. Shaun Morrison and Mendes Lang wonder goal secured a victory for us and hope that we can stay in the Premier League as well. Burnley, we were robbed, horrendous. Refereeing again just reminds us of that Chelsea match. I won't even go into detail on that one. But yeah, Liverpool, what a difficult challenge this is going to be. Once again, I'm joined by this man.
Hello.
So to his channel, link in description below. Very difficult today. While you could say a Liverpool player is probably worth the entirety of our squad put together, which is quite scary, I don't think we're really going to get anything out of this game. I think we can try our hardest, but it's just not going to happen, to be honest. And we should prepare for more important games such as Fulham and Palace, who really we need to win a game, or who we have to beat. So what's your thoughts on the game then?
Yeah, Liverpool, it's going to be a very, very difficult game this afternoon for Cardiff. It's, 24 degrees, it's going to be a hot afternoon there. Liverpool, what do? You go and attack them? If you attack them, they're going to kill you on the break with their frightening pace up front. Or do you sit back, but then after wave of attack by the Liverpool team, they'll eventually grind you down. So, how do Warnock set up against the Reds this afternoon? But hopefully we can get a goal at some point. If it's to go 1-0 up, then that would be magnificent. And then it's just, you know, the crowd will hopefully get them through. But can we even get a goal? Because defensively, they're very good as well. Cardiff got players that can hurt people, like Camaras, if we can get him on the ball and create something. I suspect that Niasse will be up front today rather than Zahor. And it'd be good to see him score at last. I know he's got one goal this season, but he's desperate for a goal. But Wolves yesterday, not carving out a victory against Brighton, was a little bit, well, it was a very disappointing, in fact. So we've got to go up against a resurgent Fulham team next weekend. I think they've won two on the bounce now. So it's going to be very, very difficult for Cardiff now until the end of the season, even after that fine win against Brighton on Tuesday evening. So I'm hopeful for today, but we haven't picked up any points against the top six. So, yeah, we'll see how it goes.
Yeah, very difficult game. I don't think we're going to win, but we just got to hope for something. Maybe Bruno Manga or someone can pop up with a 93rd minute bicycle kick.
Yeah, or a header from Manga, because we know that I suspect they'll be looking at Morrison at those set pieces. So hopefully someone like Manga can get in there, or, you know, maybe nod with him himself, because he's due a goal too.
Yeah.
And we got to think about the officials as well. Against Chelsea and Burnley, we had, well, enough said about that. They made a boo-boo in both of those matches.
Yep. Well, let's just say, well, we were robbed in both of them, to be honest. We should have had points against Burnley, 100%, because that would have been about two or three penalties and all of that. And then against Chelsea, Rudiger should have been sent off about two or three times.
That's ancient history now.
Yeah. We just got to focus on the future and wait until the team lineup comes out in about 40 minutes' time. Come on, City.
there, 10 minutes gone, Cage playing different game. Yeah, Preventer's really playing well. Our defence is solid though, which is the main thing. Hopefully so we can serve, if not, keep it at 0-0, that would be brilliant.
I think he's about to sound straight.
and on comes Bakuna now. We need to sort of show everything. So hopefully this corner won't go in. Oh, wait. What, wait?
That's the end of the match. In somewhat respects, we were unlucky, but others, referee just once again, Salah just fell over, didn't he? Just completely dive in. But then of course, because his card, if the referee gives it, it's absolutely disgusting how the referees operate in this league. Genuinely, I don't know what to say about that. What's your thoughts?
Yeah, Liverpool could say was the better side today, but there's some dubious decisions by the referee yet again. Obviously, we haven't seen a replay of the Salah penalty, but it looked very, 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 very harsh from where we were. He looked to go down so easily. If that was in at the other end, would Cardiff have got the penalty? No, not no chance. So favouring the big six yet again. Officiating throughout the match, you know, up and down throughout. You've got a question. There was only 3 minutes of added time. There was, five, six substitutions in all and injuries. So that's, eight, you could say six, seven, 8 minutes should have been added on. Would it have made a difference? Probably not. But, again, Cardiff and Dunn on the whole by a good team, but officiating yet again lets themselves down.
Who's your
man of the match for Cardiff? I would say Niasse just worked really hard. No, actually, I'll give it to... I thought Morrison had a good game today. I don't know who... For the first goal from Wijnaldum, what happened there. It was from a corner, of course. But I will give it to Morrison, I think.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to probably the entire defence, to be honest. They all had a good game, in my opinion. Peltier, Morrison, Manga and Bennett. All fantastic.
Yeah, Manga did well.
Manga, while Salah was just in his back pocket for the first half, won't need to be fair.
Yeah, they won't get much change, but they had some good chances, but they couldn't finish them off, thankfully.
Yeah, that's good
but,
now.
But
moving on, we're playing Fulham next Saturday. That's going to be very difficult since they've won their last two matches.
Yeah, well, I think it's a must win now. It's a must win. I thought maybe if Brighton hadn't picked up that point, then... A point would have been good enough, and then a victory against Palace. But yeah, both tough matches now, Palace and Fulham.
Yeah, both now must wins. If we don't win both of them, then we're going
down.
Well,
we could. It all depends, doesn't it? Really, on Brighton.
Yeah, I can't see them picking up any more points though. But
oh, you never know.
Fulham,
I think they're playing midweek as well, aren't they? I think it's Tottenham they got.
Yeah, because they've got a game in hand, haven't they? So
yeah.
But I just can't see them winning that either. They've been dreadful. So guys, if you did enjoy this video, then please do leave a like, and if this is the first ever video you've seen by me, then please do consider hitting that subscribe button and turning on the bell for notifications so you never miss an upload. Follow my social medias in the description below as well. Also, go follow my Twitch TV channel. I do frequent live streams on there. I did live stream on Saturday night. That was a good stream. Played a bit of CSGO there. Go forgive it, go follow so you never miss a live stream. And yeah, I'll see you all next time. Au revoir.